is Saturday, June 8th, 2019, Saturday of the seventh week of Easter. Of course, this weekend we are preparing to celebrate Pentecost, and on the Feast of Pentecost, our Easter season will come to a close. I think One of the things that many people believe about Catholics is that basically we're a non-scriptural church. We don't use the Bible. We don't believe in the Bible. However, I don't really think that's true.
Mm. How often do you look at the Bible?
How often? I'd say not often. Not often. Mostly I read other books like fantasy or mystery, but not often.
You read it a lot?
Yes, every day. Have you talked to a Catholic? They have like people who really, really, really want to study the Bible, they study the Bible. But then there are people who are, we don't have like lay people going as in depth as much, which is kind of a bad thing.
I mean, of course, when you look at a lot of the Baptist and Pentecostal churches, their people can quote scripture and verse right off the top of their head. Is that the gauge as to what makes a church a biblically based church? It's an interesting question. Even just some of the basic knowledge we need to have about the Bible, I think, is extremely important. And I think we need to start from looking at the Bible, not just by paragraph and verse and things like that, but to be able to understand what the Bible teaches.
So it is the go-to source if you want to know what it means to be a human person and what it means to relate to God and relate to others in general, in order that you may live this life and be happy in the next. As my religion teacher in high school always said, all the other books that I have and all my other subjects, they're good for this life. But the Bible is the book that gets you through this life and into the next.
And yes, there are many things that are said about the Bible all the time. Things like easy ways of understanding what the Bible is. Someone actually turned it into an acronym, B-I-B-L-E, Basic Information Before Leaving Earth. Pretty creative. Certainly a cute little acronym can be very helpful. However, I also find it to be somewhat trivializing of the importance and the beauty of the Bible. The reason I say that is because I find that the Bible is far more than just basic information, way more. I always liked what the bishops said at the Second Vatican Council in the document Dei Verbum, speaking of the Bible. They said it's the word of God put into written form for the sake of our salvation. The Word of God. Yes, it's the Word of God, beyond a shadow of a doubt, and it is in written form, which is a very helpful thing. But if we start from the premise that we're dealing with the Word of God, then we can really dig into the riches of what we mean by the Bible. I mean, think about it for a second. There were 2,600 Catholic bishops who produced this document. And that's why I like to always go back to that reference from Dei Verbum, that we're dealing with the Word of God. The Bible is the Word of God.
The Bible is the Word of God. It's the Word of God. It's the book that, you know, that we read to. It's a book that guides us, you know, through our life as followers of Jesus Christ.
That's the book, right? That's the book. It's the book. The book. Like, the bestseller in the whole wide world.
That's the book of Jesus' life. It's the book of life for me.
And as we know from St. John in his gospel and his letters, Jesus is the Word. Jesus is the Word of God in human flesh. Everything that we do is drawn from the Bible. As Catholics, everything comes from the Bible. Everything that we believe, anything that we ever say, whether it's from doctrine, whether it's our liturgy, our prayers, everything is drawn from the Bible.
I would say that our doctrines and our traditions come very much from the Bible. And in fact, it's that collective interpretation over history that's allowed us to be consistent in what we say and what we do. The tradition is a super important part of that.
Now, of course, down through the ages, there have been disputes over basically what comprises a Christian Bible. The books that were in the Bible were pretty much the same down through history, starting from the early church right up until the Protestant Revolt, at which time they decided that there were books that we included as Catholics that they didn't want anymore. Now, in fairness, there was good scholarship that they had done. They were working to try to bring about, if you will, a sense of some of the historical perspectives, looking back at the Jewish peoples and looking back at the early church. But the reality is, what had been the canon of the Bible for centuries, they changed.
And if there's discrepancies between the other Christian denominations out there who are sola scriptura, it's because they don't have a tradition to fall back on. So they're left to their own, in the moment, in the context, interpretations of scripture. And naturally, that causes fracturing.
So in the document Dei Verbum, the bishops do speak very much about what scripture is all about. Why do we have the Bible? It is for our salvation. One of the things that they are very clear about is that what's in the Bible is the inerrant revealed truth from God. The Bible didn't just happen. It didn't just fall out of the sky into our hands. It was under the guidance of the Holy Spirit that we received the Bible as mere human beings.
But then people get like bored with it, because then they sit there and they go, I've heard this story over and over again. And I'm like, do you really read it though? Did the purpose of what the Bible's supposed to be is, it's supposed to connect with you.
Wasabi's got a new home.
So he literally comes straight down from the meeting, doesn't even say hi, he's like, where's Wasabi? He fell out of the tree.
Okay.
So we saved him. Okay. This is Wasabi. Okay.
Blue.
He's harmless.
What? Parrot.
Mm-hmm.